Alaska Live TV. Music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska. Architecture and engineering for the new frontier.
Marc Brown and the Blues Crew. Thanks for joining me, you guys.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah.
And Marc Brown, would you introduce your crew here?
Yes. I got the Blues Crew, David Pick on the drums, and Noel Camp on the bass guitar.
And it's a trio tonight.
Yes.
I love the power trio. That's a great idea.
We've been doing it for a while. We're really getting into it.
What's the first song you've selected for Alaska Live?
It's a song that I wrote called Love is Hard to Find.
Feels to know in your heart.
Very sweet love song to start
thank
out.
Thank you.
And you wrote that song, right?
Yes, I did.
Was that a recent song that you've written, or is that?
No, I wrote it in the 90s sometime.
Back in the 90s, yeah. Speaking of the 90s, I bet you have more than one song from the 90s on your newest CD, the Greatest Hits CD,
yes,
that you just released recently.
I think we recorded that one in 2002. Yeah, it was released in 2002.
Did you re-record all these songs that you put on here, or did
I
you
remastered
take
them?
Okay.
Yeah.
That's what people do for their greatest hits, yep, CDs, right? They take the songs from the recordings they have and they remaster them. And
it's the longest CD that I have, and it was the easiest to make.
Well, you have 10 CDs previous to this. This is your 11th one, right?
Yes, it sure is.
So, had you put out a greatest hits before?
No.
It was about time.
Yes.
And it's got some newer songs on it and some older ones. Oh, Mickey Woods. I like that song a lot, too.
Yeah, we get requests for that.
Yeah. Can I ask you about the NAMI that you won?
Sure.
Yeah, that is really cool. You just last year won the Native American Music Award. It's basically the Grammys of, yep, Native American music. And you won for Best Recording.
Best Blues Recording.
Best Blues Recording.
Yep.
And that was for which recording of yours?
The Way You Walk.
The Way You Walk. Great. Well, congratulations. That's a big achievement. I know that you'd been nominated in the past, and now you won, and so it's been great to see you nominated a few times and finally get
it. It was awesome.
Yeah.
We got to go out there and play, too. That was fun.
Wow. You got to play on that stage.
Yep.
That's very nice. I bet they had a really good sound crew there and a nice audience for you.
Yeah. The stage was huge.
Well, are you ready to play another selection from your set list?
This one isn't on any CD yet. It's a song that I co-wrote with my late uncle, Peter Holchies. And it's kind of funny. He wrote the guitar riff. He wrote that part, and he called me up from the music store. And he was like, hey, I wrote this riff. You need to write some words to it. Like, can you come get me? I'm like, oh, my baby's sleeping. You know, I can't go anywhere. So he started walking to my house, and it started raining like crazy, and he got to my place and he was soaking wet. So I wrote a song, Walking in the Rain. Here it is.
Walking in the rain, feel so down. Walking in the rain, soaking wet. It's your love I can't forget. Sometimes I wonder why you don't care. Listen for the thunder, I'll be there. Walking in the rain, I'm in the rain. Sometimes I wonder why you don't care. Listen for the thunder. I'll be there walking in the rain.
Well, thank goodness for your uncle giving you the idea for that song, because it's got not just nice guitar riffs in it, it's got some really funky bass grooves in it, and something for the drummer, too. It's got all around something for everybody.
He was really brokenhearted, and so I kind of took part of his life and put it into the song.
I like that about songwriting. It probably picked him up and cheered him up a little bit to hear that, too.
We wrote four songs together. That's one of them.
You call Fairbanks home, and you've called Fairbanks home for years now. But where did you grow up, Mark?
I grew up in Huslia.
In Huslia.
It's a really big town, 300 people.
All of 300, huh?
Yep.
And that's a fly-in only village, right?
Yeah.
Or you can get there by?
Or boat or snow machine.
Because what river is that on?
On the Koyukon River.
It's on the Koyukon. So why guitar and not fiddle or drums or, even bass? Why'd you pick up the guitar?
I have no idea. I started playing it when I was four.
So wow. Whose guitar were you able to pick up when you were four?
My uncle Kenny's. And after he passed away, they actually gave me that guitar. Oh. A 1962 Gibson.
Do you still have that?
Yep, I do.
Gibson? That's
write a
amazing.
Lot of songs on there.
Oh, that's one you keep at home, probably close to your heart. Yeah. And did the rest of your family play music too? So it was the
most of them
Brown family band.
Actually, everybody in my family named Sam's. My mom got married to a Brown, and my brother and I are the only Browns. But he passed away. So.
And he played drums, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So I could have almost been Mark Sam, I guess.
You'd have been two first names. Growing up in Huslia, were there a lot of people in your town? Were they playing music? And was it rock and roll and blues, or was it a combination of Athabascan fiddle tunes?
And a lot of country and fiddling. Really good musician came from there too, Herbie Vint.
Herbie Vint?
Yep.
Is he still around?
Yeah. He is. He was the first native to put out a record, I guess.
Wow.
Way back in the day.
Yeah. So was it that you would play for gatherings, or is it more you were playing just at home, or did it start to be that you were probably asked to play at Weddings and funerals, maybe,
yeah.
Huh?
I started out playing at home, but yeah, by the time I was 14, I was playing rhythm guitar in my grandpa's band.
Oh, in your grandpa's band. Did you come to Fairbanks sometimes to play?
Yeah, my first big gig when I was 15, we played at the Eagles Hall. It was pretty awesome.
Yeah.
It was packed.
That's great. So you got a little taste of what it's like to play in front of a crowd and at a very young age, as an early teenager.
Yep.
And you played in front of a crowd like at the Nammies. And
yeah, that was like 2,800 people.
Wow, that's great. Very good. Well, you're playing in front of the radio crowd tonight and a TV eventually. So.
Yes.
We can't see them, but we know they're out there, so let's send them another song.
Okay. Here's a... I guess we're nominated for another NAMMY. Well, hopefully we win, but this song is going up for the Best Blues Recording. It's a song I wrote called I'm So Glad.
Marc Brown and the Blues Crew here for Alaska Live. I'm so glad you are here for Alaska Live, too.
Me too.
And I know the planning of this came from a bit of, hey, maybe acoustic guitar more than electric, or maybe a combination of both. And we kind of talked about that before, you know, setting a date and such. And you showed up with a very pretty acoustic guitar. It's got some nice inlays in it, Mark.
Yes, I just got this from Music Mart yesterday.
You just bought that guitar?
Yesterday, yep.
You sound great on it already.
I'd like to thank them down there. They gave me a great deal.
Oh.
Can't beat that.
It has like the beautiful, what is that, the opal inlay?
I have no idea.
It's very pretty.
I tried them all, and whatever one sounded the best, I bought it.
Like a kid in a candy store.
Yeah.
Well, everybody needs a nice acoustic guitar. Blues musicians, it sounds great when you do both the acoustic and the plugged-in electric, I think. So, and Noel, you've got an acoustic bass, too. I didn't know that you played acoustic bass. You also, yeah, there's a microphone back there for you.
Yeah, I got acoustic bass guitar. I've had this one for a couple of years, and, you know, it's just bass guitar, but yeah. Acoustic.
Yeah, and it's got some very nice inlays in it also. And
it's a pretty one.
It's a pretty one. And
it sounds great.
It really sounds great also.
Fretless.
It's a fretless bass. That's a good point.
That's
fun.
You got to be really good to play a fretless bass.
Yeah, explain that to me. What the difference between playing a fretless bass and one that has the frets, the marks on it?
I suppose you just got to pay attention a little more.
Because there's no training wheels are off at that point.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
How long have you been playing bass?
Almost 20 years.
Well, you hardly look old enough to say that.
Yeah. Yeah.
You must have been playing bass when you could just walk.
That's right. Yeah.
Hey, Dave, how you doing back there on the drums?
How are you?
Real good. Can you tell us how you found this place? Because I know that you're new. Not new to the band, but I haven't seen you here for Alaska Live before. I've had Marc Brown, the Blues Crew, in, and now it's...
There's two places in Fairbanks that drive me crazy. It's Fort Wainwright and UAF. I cannot find my way around any of those places.
Sweet.
So I started Googling yesterday. I got here at like 9:30 this morning. It's very, very early.
That's so, where the drummer is always there early.
Yes.
Text came
yes,
from.
That's true.
And you were watching the YouTube to figure out where this might be.
I YouTubed a couple of the shows here, and in your intro to the show, it shows somebody walking very fast with a guitar. And so I kept stopping the video saying, okay, I recognize that, but it was very hard to do. I finally figured it out.
Yeah, in the intro to Alaska Live, it's a sped up version of walking up from the lower parking lot, the Taku parking lot. And so I never thought that would help with directions for a band member, but thank goodness it did. David, you have been with the band for a little while now?
Yes, about a year almost.
About a year now. And your playing is intricate, and it seems like you're familiar with Mark's style. It's obvious that you've maybe seen the Blues Crew before. And
yes, well, it clicks very well. We play quite a bit together, so.
Good. Well, Dave, I'm glad you made it up here, and thank you for finding us 12 hours earlier than your show. That's awesome. All right, well, let's hear what we can do here with the three of you guys.
All right, here's a little song called Been So Long, another original.
Been
yeah. You didn't tell me why you really needed a microphone back by the drummer. Dave, you sing.
Yes, he's a great harmony singer.
That is nice to have and added to your band. You know, you pick up a drummer and a backup singer, a harmony singer, and what a wonderful idea. And you've been playing... Lately, you've been away from Alaska, or no, you've been mostly in Alaska?
Mostly here. Mm-hmm. Playing a lot of gigs in Anchorage, here in town. But we played in McGrath last weekend.
You went out to McGrath?
Yeah, that was awesome.
What kind of music festival do they have out in McGrath?
They had a really bunch of different kind of bands. I mean, they only had like five bands, but not one of them were even close to being alike. They had a fiddle group, I can't even describe what Haifa, what kind of music they played.
Haifa has been on Alaska Live, so I know exactly how it's hard
to
really explain.
They're really talented.
Yeah.
Really good.
The one guy plays the piano and drums at the same time.
Same time. Mm-hmm. That's crazy.
Yeah. Wow. So he couldn't fly out there with his piano.
They brought one for him. Yeah.
McGrath, I did not know that they had a music festival out there, but was it well attended?
I think the whole town was there.
Awesome.
A couple other villages, too.
Very good. Yeah. Oh, you didn't have this guitar yet then?
No, I played all electric.
All electric.
Yeah. I like to switch over and play some electric, if that's okay.
You bet.
Awesome.
Yeah. Well, you guys have changed from the more acoustic side to the more electric side of Marc Brown and the Blues Crew.
Yes.
And
This is what, where we strut our stuff. This is what pays the bills.
This is what pays the bills. That's what shows off your ultimate technique was the acoustic sounds, and now you've got the more plugged-in version. Oh, wow. And you have a sweet guitar strap, too, that's got some beading on it, even.
Yeah. My cousin Sophie made this for me.
Your cousin Sophie did the beading on it and made it for you? That's sweet.
She made me another one, too.
You might have to put that one on the new guitar, on the new acoustic guitar.
Yeah, I don't ever bring the other one to the bar, because see how this one kind of changed colors?
It used to be a lot lighter, you mean, and a lot more colorful?
Yes.
You do. You play in a smoky bar. You play at the Arctic Bar, right?
Yep, Friday and Saturday.
And it still has not gone non-smoking?
Not yet.
Do you see that ever happening?
I sure hope so before I die, anyway.
That's not even funny. It's true.
I like that place, but it's pretty smoky.
You need time to tune, or it's all
I just
good.
Tuned up, so
all right,
good to go.
You are a professional, Mark.
Thank you,
Marc Brown and the Blues Crew here on Alaska Live. They've changed out instruments now and are on the electric side of things. And what are we going to hear
don't
next?
I feel so nervous. Here's a little original for you, "Baby, I Love You So."
Thank you.
time. Our love is oh so fine. Oh girl, baby, I love you so. Every day and all night, all I want is to hold you tight. Oh girl, what it's gonna be? Are you gonna give your love to me? Oh girl, baby, I love you so.
Yeah. You write some darn good blues tunes,
oh,
Mark.
Thank you.
Most of what you perform is a lot of your own original tunes.
Yes, we play quite a few.
And you've been playing here in Fairbanks and around Alaska for long enough that people know your songs and probably are able to shout out requests at shows and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. You bet. Marc Brown and the Blues Crew are here for Alaska Live. They're a trio tonight, which I really think that sounds great. The trio is fun. Sometimes you've got Jason Slatz as your saxophone player, but you said that
we sure do miss him. He's doing a lot of work out in Valdez right now.
Got to work sometimes in the summertime.
Yeah, got a real job.
Pretty much.
Noel, are you saying that you don't have a real job? This is a real job. Playing music is a real job.
It ain't working. That's the way to do it.
It's fun, though, too, right?
That's right.
We play for free, but they pay us to move gear.
Oh, man. You haven't hired any roadies yet?
That'd be a
not very often.
Once your kids get old enough, Mark, they can be your roadies, right?
Yes, that'd be awesome.
You've opened for some really big shows, I know. You've opened for ZZ Top. You've opened for the Fabulous Thunderbirds, Jethro Tull, just to name a few.
Jay Giles Band, John Hammond, Eddie Shaw. I think that might be it.
What's one of the most memorable experiences from one of those big shows that you have?
Probably the ZZ Top one, because the Carlson Center was sold out. That was awesome.
Did you get to meet ZZ Top and the band?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Well, I only want to meet the guitar player, and that's who I met.
Yeah. What's his name?
Billy Gibbons.
Oh, yeah. He's got the beard. No,
yeah,
wait, they all have the beard.
Both of them do. The only guy that doesn't have a beard, his name is Frank Beard. It's
no.
Kind of weird. Yeah, the drummer.
You're kidding.
Yeah.
When you look up the word ironic in the dictionary, that's in there. that's great. Who's on the horizon for a big Carlson Center show? Do we know?
I haven't heard either. Yeah.
All right. Well, hopefully you get the call when it happens.
Though. Yeah.
Right on. Well, hey, you're all tuned up and ready to go. Let's hear another selection.
Here's another original called Broken Home. Thank you.
I'm going down this road. Broken whiskey bottle, broken home. Left my little girl all alone. Ain't got no money to call her on the phone. I really need you, baby. All I ever wanted was you. I really love you, darling.
Song to see if you had put that on the greatest hits CD, but I noticed you didn't.
Really?
Oh.
Oh yeah, that was the 17th song. That's how good that album is.
Yep. That's the one that didn't make the cut.
Yeah.
Ah, oh, that's a good one.
Yep.
And I'm sure these are all beated out somehow, but that's a great song, and it's got such good riffs in it too. No, you've got that bass that you just had a bit ago. You have three basses in here. You did earlier.
Yeah.
It has an extra string, or two, or three, or four. It's an eight-stringed one.
Eight-string bass guitar.
Very nice.
Yeah.
I didn't.
Fun instrument. It's like the equivalent to a 12-string guitar, but it's a four-string bass with sympathetic drone octave strings next to each regular string. So. Basically plucking and fretting two strings at once. And
yeah, and you play it usually with a pick, it looked like.
Yeah, mm-hmm. mostly down strokes.
Uh-huh,
Pardon me while I switch guitars again.
Hey, no problem. It was only minorly scary when I saw just three of you show up with kind of what I would describe as a ton of gear. But then once you got it all in here and we arranged it and everything was fine, but it all fit right here. And
we've been around the block a few times. We kind of know what we're doing.
You have been even around this block before.
Yes.
Marc Brown, you're no stranger to KUAC's Alaska Live. You've been here before. And it seems to me last time you were here, you were talking about heading down to the lower 48 for a battle of the bands. Do you remember that?
We went to one in 2008. don't know if that's how long we did.
I don't know.
Yeah, we took fourth out of 1,008 bands.
Nice. So you took...
Basically got a pat on the back for fourth.
Oh, because you
didn't... Good job, guys.
Because you didn't get third.
Yeah.
So you sort of placed, right?
Yeah, it was fun, though.
That's great. It's
better than fifth place.
Hey, that's right. Because you missed third by one there, yeah.
We were in Los Angeles. We didn't wear enough makeup.
Yeah.
You need to wear more makeup in L.A., huh?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Those guys that won were...
They were very pretty.
Yeah. You know, they have fake everything down there.
That's
so
right.
It was quite an experience, though.
Well, yeah. I mean, Alaskans hit L.A. You can't beat that. Yeah.
We're the only band out of Alaska that ever placed, that even made it to the finals.
Gotcha. So cool. Was that one of those battle of the bands where they take the best from some states or not every state?
They had a Pacific Northwest Championship.
Okay.
They usually have it in Seattle, but they had it in Anchorage, and we lost by one vote. We took second, but they still sent us out there anyway.
Awesome. And then you ended up placing fourth down there, so they made the right choice. The baby blue guitar has come out. What kind of guitar do you have this time?
That's actually its name, Baby Blue.
No way.
Yeah.
It's a Baby Blue Ibanez?
No, that's just what I named it.
Oh, you named it.
It's
very nice.
Ibanez Tallman.
That's a very pretty, pretty solid body guitar. Marc Brown and the Blues Crew are here for Alaska Live, and they are made up of David Peck on drums, Noel Camp on bass, and Marc Brown doing the vocals and lead guitar.
Yes. We're professionals. Don't try this at home.
Right on.
Here's a song that we won the NAMMY with last year. So if you guys vote, we might win again. Don't forget to vote. NativeAmericanMusicAwards.com.
Love the way you walk, I love the way you talk, I do. Love the way you kiss, only girl I miss, it's true. Need your loving, I hope you need me too. Gonna let you go. Love you, baby. I ain't never gonna let you go. Need your loving. I thought you might like to know. It's true. Need your loving. I hope you need me too.
The way you describe it, it's like a People's Choice Award. Because you can go vote as a listener or as a fan.
I think anybody can vote.
And anybody can vote.
Yes.
And so is the voting from the fans the only thing they take into account, or is it a panel of judges that make the final decision?
Yeah, if it's really close, they have judges, but mostly it's just the fans.
Love that idea. You know, it really is power to the people on that.
We were very humbled to win. Mm.
So is it too soon to ask what the next album is out? I know that you just put out the greatest hits, but I bet you're working on another one.
Yeah, we actually recorded a few songs, but we didn't finish them. And I'm not sure what the name will be yet.
So it's in the process. You're already recording.
Yeah, Walking in the Rain. A couple of new originals are on there. So,
Walking in the Rain, that's one of them that you did here.
Yeah, a little while ago, acoustic.
Yeah, inspired by your uncle. Like that one. Yeah. Well, it's about that time. What do you think? Got time for one more?
Okay.
Great.
Which one of those you want to do? Might as well that one,
you,
I guess.
You have choices. I like that. You're left with choices.
Yep.
Here's so what'd you decide on?
It's called Going to Anchorage. We go there quite a bit, so we had to write some kind of song about it.
Did you write it on the way?
Actually, I woke up in the middle of the night, and it was kind of a dream. And so
nice.
Kind of half awake and half sleeping. And then when I woke up, like a few hours later, put it down on paper.
Guitar by my side. I'm going down to Anchorage. Got my guitar by my side. I'm going down on my baby. Too many nights that she's crying. I'm going down to A-Town. Just me and my guitar. Down to A-Town. Just me and my guitar. She's away so far.
Yes, that is how it's done. Marc Brown and the Blues Crew, thank you so much for being here. David Peck on drums, keeping down the drum line down there, and Noel Camp on bass.
Yes, thank you so much for having us.
And Marc Brown on the Waylon guitar riffs there. And it's been my pleasure to host. I'm your host, Lori Neufeld. And Marc, come back sometime.
Would love to.
You can find full episodes of Alaska Live TV online at kuac.org. Alaska Live TV, music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio, is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska, architecture and engineering for the new frontier.